मेरे ससुराल वाले मानसिक शारीरिक रूप से प्रताड़ित कर रहे हैं। मेरा पति दोनों नंदे मुझे 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 गंदा बाथरूम, घर का गंदा बाथरूम, टॉयलेट एवं अपने गंदे अंडरगार्मेंट साफ करने कहती है, और सभी लोग मेरे साथ मारपीट गाली गलौज करके घर से बाहर निकाल देते थे और मुझे गालियां सास ससुर सोन से कहकर भोपाल में धमकी देते, तुम्हें जान से माने तुम्हें लाश गायब करवा देंगे। मेरे ससुर अपने काले कोट वकालत करने वाले बड़े लोगों को जान पहचान बताकर उससे डराते थे एवं गंदी गंदी मामन की गालियां देते थे। मेरा पति मेरे चरित्र पर संदेह करता, मैं कॉलेज में मेरे मायके ये सब फैलाई किसी लड़के साथ अफेयर चल रहा है। मेरे ससुराल में आत्महत्या करने के उठाते क्योंकि उनकी पैसे मांग पूरी नहीं कर पाए थे और खाना पीने नहीं देते थे। मेरे पति मुझे अननेचुरल सेक्स करने के लिए भी जबरदस्ती करता था, मना करने पर मुझे नहीं मानता, काफी पीड़ा होती थी, गालियां हैं। फिर 2019 को मेरे ससुराल वाले मुझे घर के बाहर निकाल दिया और मुझे अपने मायके सागर आ गए तथा दो आ गई वहां से आ गई मेरे फूफा ससुर इंद्रजीत हैं पूना में एवं परिवार के आश्वासन की अब तुम्हारी सर किसी प्रकार की परेशानी बाबा बुला लिया। जब मुझे ससुराल वालों ने साजिश का पता चला तो जान से मारने प्लानिंग कर रहे हैं, तब मैंने मायके की व्यथा बताया, वुमेन सेल पर बेलापुर महाराष्ट्र में एक आवेदन दिया जिसकी 22 अप्रैल 2019 को मेरे ससुराल वाले तरफ मुझ पर एवं परिवार को सागर लाकर लगातार लगातार धमकाया जाए ताकि उनके विरुद्ध किसी प्रकार का कोई कार्रवाई करने से रखते। मेरे पति राहुल राहुल नंद मीनल अहिंसा मुझे लगातार जान से धमकी देगा, मुझे परिवार को मुंबई से करके मैं मुंबई से मैं परिवार वालों को जान से मारने के लिए माइकल सागर कर दी गई। मैं मेरी मुंबई महाराष्ट्र में काउंसलिंग हो चुकी है, मैं किस पर काउंसलिंग नहीं चाहती हूँ, अतः माननीय महोदय निवेदन कि निम्न व्यक्ति उचित कार्रवाई करने की स्वयं से कार्रवाई की जाए और 11 से 2019 को एफआईआर लॉजिक दी। एफआईआर नाउ व्हाट आई हमली सबमिट, मतलब इट्स अ एलिगेशन व्हिच इज कम्प्लीटली बाल्ड व्हिच हैज बीन लेवल्ड अगेंस्ट द प्रेजेंट एप्लीकेंट्स व्हिच इज देयर। नाउ इफ यू सी टू दी डॉक्यूमेंट, दिस डॉक्यूमेंट वॉज नॉट मेड अ पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ दिस वुमेन्स एंड बेलापुर में जो एप्लीकेशन दी गई।
So many very serious allegations have been made, and this fact is not under dispute that the applicants were residing at that time in that flat itself, which is clear from the allegations made in the FIR. It has been made. Not all these facts are required to be adjudicated in the trial. I'm not the matter is at the stage of the framing of charge before the court at Sagar. So, not my respectful submission, not if we read it carefully, not. The allegations, even I cannot read it now because there are very serious allegations against the husband and the family members. And for that purpose, I would like to refer the petition, paragraph 2, 5, 8, and 9, in which they themselves have admitted this fact, Lord, in the petition, that they were residing at Bombay. So the incident had taken place at Bombay. And Lord, the FIR has been lodged on 11-6-2019 at Sagar. Not all these facts are covered by the judgment of this court as also by the Apex Court. But I am placing this is the judgment of this court in miscellaneous criminal case number 2964 of 2024. Only I would refer page 11.
Okay, sir.
That is clause 14 of that has been reproduced. Not from the reading of the complaint, it cannot be held that even if the allegations are taken as proved, no case is made out. There are allegations against respondent number 2 and his parents for harassing the complainant, which forced her to live in the matrimonial home. Even now, she continues to be separated from the matrimonial home as she apprehends lack of security and safety and proper environment in the matrimonial home. The question whether the appellant has in fact been harassed and treated with cruelty is a matter of trial. But at this stage, it cannot be said that no case is made out. Thus, questioning of the proceedings before the trial court is not permissible. The decision referred in the judgment so-and-so is distinguishable. And thereafter, my lord, in paragraph 11, so many judgments have been referred by your lordship. And at page 13, lord, it starts with thus. This court can quash the proceedings only if the uncontroverted allegations do not make out an offense. From the plain reading of the FIR, it cannot be said that no causable offense is made out. So far, the territorial and then territorial jurisdiction and the 2019 volume 5 SCC 384 Rupali Devi's case that has also been referred, my lord. And in that, my lord, the mental cruelty, my lord, it continues. Because whatever she has sustained over there, that has continued after shifting to Sagar. So she was very much competent to lodge the FIR, and the lord that jurisdiction was challenged. And the lord in the last date of hearing, that petition has been withdrawn because they raised an objection with regard to mental ability of the petition at Sagar. And that was against that revision was preferred. Then the 482 proceedings were filed. It was withdrawn. So, my lord, these points are yet to be adjudicated.
So what is the number of that 482?
Flagged, my lord, that first.
Now, the humble submission which I will be making, my lord. would be whatever my learned friend has just pointed out. It's a bald version which has come over here. Adverse, it can be said that the allegations are against the husband. Let us read to those allegations which are there on record. I don't say, Lord, I would not be saying that at this particular juncture, Lord should be holding a trial. But let us assume to be there, whatever the allegations are there. Now, does an offense under section 498A of the IPC, or it is a means to harass the entire family out over here who are already implicated. Now, the applicant before lordships happened to be the unmarried sisters, Nand hai do. That is applicant number 2 and applicant number 3. Now, she has not made any allegation that she was ever subjected to cruelty at Bhopal. Kindly consider this aspect, Maharaj. Whatever has she made an allegation, what has happened at Mumbai, and that is the allegations are against the husband. Bald version ki unne bola ki bathroom dhulwane ki baat kari ho, dusri baat nahi kari. Barring that, there is no allegation that these persons have ever demanded dowry or they have harassed this lady. Now, so far as the mother and father are concerned, they were residing at Bhopal. She had, doesn't say that they had come down over there, they had subjected her to cruelty. Now, Maharaj, what, so far as the other petition, that was the jurisdiction, I'm not touching the jurisdiction aspect. I'm on the merits of the matter. Jurisdiction aspect is not being touched, that the offense could not be got registered. The law is well settled on that point, that wherever the lady goes, she can go and lodge a report. Earlier, that's why Abraham Ajit and the subsequent judgment, Ramesh versus State of Tamil Nadu, they have been held that in spite that a report can be lodged if she goes to her parental home and she lodges a report. On that aspect, that's Rupali Devi's judgment is very much clear. But so far as the offense under section 498 is concerned, let us limit ourselves at this particular juncture. We read to the allegation. It is not moderate, it is not every type of cruelty. I need not elaborate on that issue, sir. Lodges are well aware as to the scope of section 498.
Lordship is well aware.
On that issue. And then we go down to the judgment of Geeta Malhotra. And then the judgment of Achin. They make an allegation. It has to be seen from the touchstone. Now, whether these girls who were there residing and doing their own work. Now, it is one family who is staying over there. The dispute is with the husband and the wife. The wife never wanted to live along with the other persons over there. So, the easiest way is make allegations. Some disputes arose, no dispute about it, Maharaj. But that is against the husband. Let's assume for the sake of argument. Not so far as these persons are concerned, the prosecuting the entire family for no fault of their, and lodges are much aware of that judgment of Kansraj versus State of Punjab, that's 2000 AI 2000 Supreme Court page 2324, where they say a tendency has happened, especially in case of dowry deaths, especially so also for offences in section 4, that the entire family is roped in over there. In those circumstances, lordship may be kind of to kindly
but consider. But in one case, one or two cases, Supreme Court has also held that the lawyer should use their good office to.
I would say, Malo, let us resolve the issue.
इसमें कुछ ऐसे allegations दिख रहे हैं जो ऐसा लग रहा है कि lawyer के dictation पे.
Very serious
allegation. Oh, lawyer के dictation में.
I'm not reading that FIR. Not very serious allegations
have. मैंने आज तक कभी भी 498A की FIR में ये नहीं देखा कि मैं आत्महत्या करने के लिए मजबूर हो रहा हूँ. तो वो सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जो ये डायरेक्शंस होता है नॉट टू एस्केलेट द डिस्प्यूट बट टू यूज द गुड ऑफिस टू रिकंसिलिएट, वो उस पर कोई क्यों नहीं मानता?
हम कर रहे ना सर,
आपकी बात नहीं कह रहा सर.
नहीं, मैं तो साहब को बोलता हूँ, बैठा ले,
आपकी बात भी नहीं कर रहा सर. शुरुआत जहाँ से होती है, देखिए एलिगेशन आप लोग नहीं बनाते हैं, एलिगेशन का आंसर वर्मा साहब नहीं दे रहे हैं. एक्चुअल एस्पेक्ट के ऊपर बोथ आर आर्गुइंग ऑन द लीगल एस्पेक्ट कि वेदर लीगली इट इज परमिसेबल फॉर दिस कोर्ट टू क्वेश और नॉट, पर जहां से शुरू होता है वहां पे सुप्रीम कोर्ट को कोई नहीं मानता. कारण क्या है? परिवार लड़ रहे हैं आपस में. और तो और सर, आपने ये भी कहा था सर कॉम्प्रोमाइज यही होगा, आपने ये भी कहा था कॉम्प्रोमाइज तो सर यही होता है.
मैं तो खुद बोलता हूँ, It is ultimately the good offices which work over here and the bane from what comes from lordships. Keeping us out of from here with those two persons made to stand over there, the entire matters can be got resolved.
Chalo, mate.
We go down to Preeti Gupta's judgment, Maloch. I need not.
क्या पॉल प्रीति गुप्ता कंसराज चंद्रलेखा
वो तो है सर
बहुत सारे
दैट इज वन एस्पेक्ट सर दिस अनदर एस्पेक्ट आल्सो टू द होल इशू which
sir sir actually actually
the father-in-law is not he is coming across in fact this is the fact position husband wife have no dispute but father-in-law is coming across he doesn't want this lady should live with that
ab wo sir dekhiye main hamesha kehta hu 482 mein neither I can say that the allegations in the FIR are correct nor I can say that the defense which is being put forward is wrong the only reservation for me is that I have to treat the FIR as a gospel truth that is the legal fiction not a finding by the court that is a limitation on my jurisdiction how to appreciate the things but once I cannot conduct a mini trial then I cannot give a finding either in your favor nor in his favor so I have to consider whether the offenses would be made out by plain reading of the allegations or not that is the only हो सकता है कि आपका एफआईआर गलत हो बट आई एम हेल्पलेस सो फार एज दिस स्टेज इज कंसर्न नॉट फॉर ऑल टाइम्स टू कम अगर ये इसको आप जनरल स्टेटमेंट देंगे तो वो आपको कहेंगे कि हाईकोर्ट इज हेल्पलेस नो बट एट दिस स्टेज ऑफ 482 अदरवाइज अगर क्रिमिनल अपील आती है देन द एंटायर प्ले ग्राउंड इज ओपन फॉर अस वो एस्पेक्ट है सर तो लेट अस नॉट सी कि भाई हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल हु इज नॉट रिस्पॉन्सिबल वी विल गो बाय द facts or allegations mentioned in the FIR and then we will decide sir
in the larger aspect also that may kindly be considered and one more thing if ultimately lawyers are not agreeing then I would
sir, no, sir.
rather than coming on to merits I would say
sir
but so far the unmarried girls the parents in laws they that can